In this video, we're going to talk about linear, constant, and quadratic functions. Any function of the form f of x is equal to x plus b is called a linear function. But a should be different from zero, and a and b both should be elements of set of real numbers. Like, we do have a function f of x equal to x plus b here. If a is zero, the function will be changed into just the form f of x equal to b, and that's another function. It's not linear. So to keep the function just linear, a should be always different from zero. Then we do have some illustrative examples here. F of x is equal to 2x minus 1. F of x is equal to minus 2x. F of x is equal to minus 1 over 4x plus 4 over 5. These are all types of linear functions. So you do have two variables here. The first variable is x and the other one is f of x. By the way, the first one, f of x equal to x minus 1, can be expressed in the form of y is equal to 2x minus 1. Even the other one, y is equal to minus 2x, y is equal to minus 1 over 4x plus 4 over 5. So you can use y on behalf of f of x here, it doesn't matter. But functions in this form are called linear functions. Here, there are some basic properties that you should always remember, that you should always know when you start thinking about linear functions. The first thing, when we consider numbers as values of x, those numbers are just from set of real numbers, and every real number makes the function, any linear function, valid. You can consider any arbitrary number and the function is always valid. So this means the domain of every linear function is the set of all real numbers. Even its range. When you consider any arbitrary number as value of x, the value of y is an element of set of real numbers. So the value of y can be positive, it can be zero, it can be negative, and it can be fraction, decimal, whatever. But it's an element of set of all real numbers always. Then you can generalize that the domain and range of any linear function is the set of all real numbers. Then when we talk about linear functions, they are always in the form of f of x equal to x plus b, and a is different from zero. But if a is zero, the function will be changed into the form f of x is equal to b, because zero will be multiplied with x, then the function will be changed into f of x equal to b. And functions of this form are called constant functions. Let's see some illustrative examples. The first one, f of x is equal to 2, and the other one is f of x equal to minus 3 over 2, and f of x equal to 0.7. If it's always a constant, and if it's written in the form of f of x equal to 2 or minus 3 over 2 or 0.7, anyway, any arbitrary real number, so this function is always called a constant function. Then I just tried to write the function in the form f of x equal to 0x plus b here. See, I just try to indicate that the function can be written in the form of linear function, but the coefficient of x is always zero. So this helps you to identify the domain of any constant function. Means, you're going to consider some numbers from set of real numbers as values of x, then you will observe the value of the function, and so that you can understand the behavior of all constant functions. So let's go to the first function. You can write f of x equal to 2 in the form of f of x is equal to 0x plus 2. The value of x doesn't matter here. Maybe the value of x can be any number, like just zero, any negative number, any positive number, but the value of the function is always 2. So when you consider any arbitrary real number as value of x, the function is always defined, always valid. Means the domain of the function is always the set of real numbers. Set of real numbers. But we have said that the valid function is always the number, the constant number. Means the image of every value of x is always the constant number. So the range of the function is the constant number, which is described by B. So the domain is the set of all real numbers, and the range of every constant function is the constant number itself. Let's proceed to the other function, which is in the form of f of x equal to x squared plus bx plus c, and this is called a quadratic function. And a, b, and c must be from set of real numbers, and a should be different from zero. Because you also understand that if a is zero, the function will be changed into the form f of x equal to bx plus c. Then it's not going to be a quadratic function. It's going to be a linear function. And then we should make a different from zero. Let's see some illustrative examples. The first one is f of x equal to x squared minus 3x plus 1. And we have another example, f of x equal to 2x squared minus 1. Then if we keep like the value of a different from 0, then the function will be always quadratic, because it's going to be degree 2 function. So that's called a quadratic function. Now let's talk about the domain and range of any quadratic function, considering just this given illustrative examples. The first one, f of x is equal to x squared minus 3x plus 1. So if you want to find the value of the function at certain values of x, so you can consider such values of x from set of real numbers, and then the function is always valid. So you can consider any number, and the function will be valid, means the domain of the function is a set of all real numbers. Considering any arbitrary real number as value of x, if the function is defined, so we can conclude that the domain of every quadratic function is the set of all real numbers. The range of the function is dependent on the values of the coefficients of the terms within the given function. So I just try to explain the standard form of any quadratic function is just f of x equal to x squared plus bx plus c. Then the values of a, b, and c just determines the range of the function. So we can't have a constant, a fixed range of all quadratic functions. So since all quadratic functions have different coefficients of the terms that they have, so their range is going to be different. They don't have the same range. So the range of a quadratic function depends on the values of a, b, and c.